Discussing the topic of gonorrhea, because this is a very important topic, and I have taken this gonorrhea topic from evidence-based textbook of obstetric and gynecology. And basically this is the a type of maternal infection. Means today we will be discussing gonorrhea in pregnancy. Okay, so first of all, let us discuss the causative agent. Gonorrhea is caused by Neisseria gonorrhea, which is basically a gram-negative intracellular diplococci. It's very important to remember because MCQs comes to related to this topic. Now, where is it isolated from? It is isolated from genital tract, from rectum, from pharynx, from eyes. Now, what is the mean of transmission? The mean of transmission is direct inoculation of infected secretion, ascending infection. Now, what are the different risk factors? The risk factors include younger age group, multiple sex partners, IV drug users, and other sexually transmitted infections. Now, what is the percentage of asymptomatic women having gonorrhea? That percentage is 30 to 60%. Now, what are the symptoms of gonorrhea? The symptoms of gonorrhea include, first of all, vaginal discharge, which occurs in 50% of the cases, lower abdominal pain, which occurs in 25% of the cases, bleeding during or after intercourse, disseminated infection 1%, fever, arthritis, and skin disorders. Then, how would we diagnose the case of gonorrhea? That is by selective culture media. Now, what are the complications in pregnancy? Complications include miscarriages, preterm labor, pre-labor rupture of membrane, STA fetus. Now, complication at the time of the delivery is also important, and if infection occurs along with the rupture of membrane, there is risk of neonatal transmission of 30 to 50%. Now, neonatal gonococcal infection presents with bilateral purulent conjunctivitis, and management is by prompt treatment with antibiotic, and that is very important because if we don't treat her, the baby can results in having blindness. Okay, so prompt antibiotic treatment is required to prevent blindness. Now, how would you manage? The pregnant women are managed in the same way as the non-pregnant woman. And the management include taking swabs, isolation, and use of antibiotics. Now, which antibiotics are used? Different regimes are used, but the commonly prescribed regimen is ceftriaxone 500 mg IM plus 1 gram azithromycin. Okay, means rocefin 500 mg IM. Okay, it is given in a single dose. Ceftriaxone 500 mg IM as a single dose along with 1 gram azithromycin. Okay, and different exam questions come related to the topic of gonorrhea. Let me give you one example. So the question is, which one of the following is correct in relation to Neisseria gonorrhea? A. Culture requires anaerobic medium. B. It is not recognized cause of neonatal ophthalmia neonatorum, neonatal sticky eyes. C. It infects superficial mucosal surfaces lined with squamous epithelium. D. Untreated may cause syndrome of fever, skin lesion, arthritis, and endocarditis. And E. Vaccine preventing transmission exists. Among all the options which are given, D seems to be correct. That is, untreated may cause a syndrome of fever, skin lesion, arthritis, and endocarditis. Another exam question, which of the following is not true about Neisseria gonorrhea infection? A. Almost half of the cases with gonorrhea may be asymptomatic. B. Heavy menstrual bleeding is known symptom. C. Neisseria gonorrhea or gram-negative bacilli. D. Pharyngitis, meningitis, endocarditis are known presentation. And E. Postcoital or intermenstrual bleeding can be seen in cases with cervicitis. Okay, the answer is C, which is Neisseria gonorrhea or gram-negative bacilli. It's not true because Neisseria gonorrhea are gram-negative intracellular diplococci. Okay, thank you so much for your patience. That's the end of the video, and I would like you to check EBM book for that.